Hi, I'm Julio Arca, and you're watching Mariners TV.
John, what were your thoughts on that game?
Yeah, obviously, yeah, it's another win. That's the most important thing. It's 19 wins on the spin now. It wasn't pretty today. It was never going to be with the conditions. You know, I think the referee and his two officials, you know, I think they were having a little bit of a doubt about putting the game on as well. But full credit to them, they got the game on. I thought first half, I thought we were only in second gear. You know, we had a little bit of a go at the lads at half time, you know. I thought we needed to raise our tempo a lot more, which we did. Second half, we got more into third, fourth gear. And that's where we got the goals. You know, we put a lot of work in, a lot of closing down. And one, if you work hard and the rest of the team work hard, everything else falls into place. Your passing, your finishing, you know, your ball retention, you know, all through your tempo. And I thought the tempo was much better second half. And to be fair, you know, the squad's been down to bare bones today. And you've got to take your hat off to the lads. You know, a great second half performance and another great 3 points.
Did you feel in that first half maybe you were changing the game too much because of the conditions, would you say?
No, I just thought, like I said, we didn't have a tempo. I thought Lee Paul Scroggins, you know, he was outstanding throughout the 90 minutes. I thought first half, he was fantastic. I just thought the tempo of the team in the first half, it was, we'll just do enough. And I said to the lads at half-time, you know, our record will be broken today if we don't raise our tempo. But Phil, again, full credit to the lads. I thought second half, they raised the tempo. Like I said earlier, everything else fell into place. The passing, you know, the finishing was much better because of the harder work rate.
Warren Byrne, the hat trick as well. Did he show exactly what he's about again?
Yeah, he took his goals really well. Fantastic. You know, his third one was brilliant. You know, he went to see what the back line was doing and they stayed there. And then he had a touch and they came out and he went round and it was a great finish. You know, and I'm pleased for Warren because obviously it's a hat trick for him. You know what I mean? And pleased for the team. You know, because I questioned them at half time. You know, I questioned the lads at half time. You know, about the desire, and they were fantastic. They showed why they're top of the league. You know.
You mentioned there was a few lads out there as well. Does it impress you that you've managed to win a game so comfortably without a few good players as well?
Yeah, definitely. It shows you the strength of the squad. You know, we've lost three big players in the last few days. Obviously, Lewis Galvin broke his leg. Lewis Teasdale's broke his hand. And Adam Curry, you know, gone off to Hull City. So they're three big players to be without. And then obviously you have Daryl Hall missing and Adam Saka missing. You know, it's five players out of your squad. But it just shows the character of the lads we've got in there. You know, they've put a great second half performance in them. And they've shown why we're top of the league, you know.
You mentioned the run up of this game as well, how important it was that was on, so you've got some preparation for more for next week as well.
Yeah, we needed that, we needed the game. And again, they're not a bad side at all. I thought they showed it in spells in the first half, they can get it down and pass. I thought the front four were good. So it was a test for them, and a good run of form. Speaking to their manager before the game, they quite fancied themselves this season to do well and maybe get promotion next season. So it was always going to be tough, they've got some good players. But we've done really well. We've getting the game in, which we needed, like we said, before the big game on Saturday. Hopefully the weather stays kind and we'll get the game on. We'll have two good training sessions and we'll get ready for the biggest game of the season by a mile in Morpeth in the FA of ours, you know.
Were you frustrated at times in that first half as well with the amount of time it was taken for the ball to come back on as well?
Yes. And if you notice the second half, the ball was coming on very quickly. But you know that's what they dug up, you know what I mean? If it was the other way around, we would certainly have the balls there. We wouldn't put them in the bag like they did, you know. So, but there you go. That's up to them, you know. We've done our job well today. We came here, we've getting three goals. A little bit unlucky we didn't see the game out and get a clean sheet because I thought that the back line defended really well second half. In the midfield in front of them and the front two, we did defend a lot better as a team. It would have been nice to get the clean sheet because I thought they deserved that for the second half performance, but it wasn't to be. A little bit sloppy towards the end, but 3 points is 3 points. It's a fantastic 3 points, and you've got to thank them supporters today. Probably a lot of them didn't think the game would be on, but you've heard them, they've been singing throughout. I don't know, but there's 150, 200 fans there. Absolutely fantastic. I'm over the moon and send them home with another win, 19 on the spin.
You mentioned Morton before as well. How strong are they as a team, would you say?
Yeah, more of a good side. You know, obviously there for years. Obviously, you know, the chairman really well. You know, they're really fancying themselves this season to do really well and everything they're going for. They've got some good players, you know, really good players. And we've watched them, we know everything about them. You know, they've watched us, they'll know about us. Just hopefully, you know, we can perform really well like we have done in the Vars and get through to the next round. We've had some really tough draws in the Vars and the lads have come out of them every time with good results. But this will be a really, really tough one. It'll be the hardest one we've had. And hopefully, you know, we can play as well as we can and win the next round in the hat.
A special tie for you personally as well, a side you've got a good affinity with, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I was there for a long time, you know. We had a really good side. Obviously, Ken Beattie, fantastic chairman I had. Still good friends, you know. Like I said, he's got a really good side there. I'm over the moon that they're doing well. I'd like to see them win the Northern League if they could. I'd like to see them knocked out of the Vars on Saturday, of course I would, you know. But yeah, got a lot of friends there, a lot of time for people there, but that goes out the window. We want to get in the next round of the Vars on Saturday, and hopefully we'll do that.